As an anthropologically trained user researcher, my favorite research to conduct relies on qualitative methods to generate deep insights like usability testing. Sometimes, however, it can be useful to pair these qualitative methods with the rigor and specificity of quantitative metrics. Two quantitative metrics that pair well with usability testing are the System Usability Scale, or SUS, and the Single Ease Question, or SEQ. The System Usability Scale, or SUS, is a series of 10 Likert questions in which a user assesses the overall usability of a system. It is typically administered at the very end of a usability test, after a user has had the opportunity to experience the system fully. The researcher can then take all of the user's responses to all 10 questions and calculate a single SUS score, which ranges from 0 to 100. The scale has existed since the 1980s, and as a result, there are relatively reliable benchmarks for what constitutes a good SUS score for different industries, making the score an excellent tool for benchmarking. On the flip side, it is a relatively blunt instrument. It assigns a single score to an entire system, rather than looking granularly at individual pages or tasks. Therefore, it can be hard to diagnose from a low SUS score where the actual problem lies. On the other hand, the single ease question, as the name suggests, is a single question typically administered after each task in a usability test. A user is asked to rate the ease of the task, typically on a 1 to 7 scale. This provides a granularity that is missing from the SUS. An analyst is able to compare the SEQ scores from the various parts of the system, allowing them to more easily detect and diagnose actionable issues. Unlike the SUS, however, there is no industry-level data available for what constitutes a good or bad SEQ score. It is only relevant in relation to the other scores on the system. Because the SUS and SEQ have different strengths and weaknesses, you're going to use them in different instances. Reach for the SUS if you're looking to benchmark a product or system over time, or relative to industry averages. On the other hand, if you're looking to identify problems or weaknesses in a system so you can diagnose and fix them, the SEQ is the way to go. Another way to think of it, SUS tends to live in a KPI dashboard. SEQ is generally found in a usability report. One final note of caution, be wary of metrics-loving executives who might be tempted to use these metrics to gloss over the qualitative insights that you uncover through testing. For various reasons, users might be likely to artificially inflate a SUS or SEQ response, even if they were clearly struggling during a usability test. A high SEQ score does not negate qualitative findings. If the two conflict, I tend to believe the observational qualitative data over the self-reported quantitative. So use these tools with caution. Make sure you're using the right one in the right context, and you'll be better armed to communicate your usability findings with confidence.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at this over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, ngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live hands-on UX training.